Hey boys, hey girls, it's time to clean my cooktop again, and Miss Debbie with Stanley Home Products sent me this deep greaser concentrate to try out with some of their special little scrubbies. So we're going to try that out on our cooktop over here. Should probably have a little spray bottle, but I don't have one. I cut a little bitty slit in the degreaser concentrate, and we're going to apply it, and I'm going to get a paper towel and kind of wipe it around and let it soak in. This is the worst area right in here around these burners, so we're going to put it on pretty heavy right in there. And I see this stuff is pretty thick, like a soap. So let me rub that around. I should probably wear gloves, but Cajun's hands as tough as alligators. This shit is badass, son. It cleaned this damn cooktop. It had burnt on carbon around these burners. I mean, food just burnt on black. I've tried scraping at it with a knife. It laughed. The carbon did. I've tried Scotch-Brite, even the brown one, which is more abrasive. The brown one scratched my cooktop up. I've even taken this and one of these and cut it in a circle and put it on one of those cupped wire brush wheel of my battery drill and got out on it. The carbon laughs. You're stupid for trying it. This stuff right here, this Stanley Home Products degreaser concentrate, I put it on the whole thing. I tested it on this one at first, and it was just eating that crap up. I left it sit on there for about 35 minutes, and then I got on it with one of their little microfiber stainless steel pads. Very, very little elbow grease was involved. Whereas you could scrub at it all day long till your arm fell off with this son of a bitch, and it didn't do nothing. I should have taken a picture before, a close-up of the stuff I'm talking about. I'm gonna take a picture, a close-up in macro now, and you're gonna see some scratches in it from prior attempts to clean this crap off. And you also see some real clean areas that had that carbon stuff on them that aren't scratched because the carbon was covering them. This stuff works. Contact Miss Debbie Jackson. Miss Debbie Jackson. She's a Fuller Brush, works for Fuller Brush Company and Stanley Home Products. Her rep number is, her representative number is 0538667. And I believe they'll ship products worldwide. Please mention her name or her rep number if you're going to order online, so she'll get credit, because she sent me this free of charge to try after she saw me using that crud cutter, which worked okay, but it didn't touch that burn on stuff. Her cell number is area code 919-343-9321. You can order direct from her. If you're out of the United States, you can go online to, you go to stanleyhomeproducts.com, and please mention Miss Debbie's rep number so she'll get credit for you buying products. Or the Fuller Brush Company's website is shoponline.com. Put the W's in front, you know that. And she sent me a little flyer. You're written in Spanish and English. 50 ways to use this product. Kitchen, bedroom, bathroom, laundry, miscellaneous uses, toys. You can even, it'll even clear your drain line out if you screwed up and stopped it up. Anyway, this stove has had a lot of neglect, a lot of use actually, and we let it go too long without cleaning it, and that's how it got really screwed up. And I was fixing to replace the top. You can buy a new skin for it, but you got to take it all apart. They sell them, but this made it like new again, except for the scratches that I put in it trying to clean it with the wrong shit. How you like that? This stuff rocks, dude. Buy some, try it. You can use it on everything. It even says it'll boost your laundry detergent. It's like, what's that other stuff that guy was selling that got busted? Put it in your toilet, put it in your laundry. OxyClean, whoever. That ain't it. Fuller Brush Company and Stanley Home Products got all kind of cool stuff in their catalog that you need to go buy. Look, they even got health food, nutrients, and brushes. Now you can comb your hair. Can you see in the, see, look, big catalog. That would degrease them. Brushes, super foaming, health foods, with a hot chick running through the glade with the ocean in the background or the sky. Well, maybe she's on a mountaintop. Cool. Thanks, Miss Debbie, for the tip and use of the product. Y'all go buy it, try it for yourself. If you don't like it, don't tell me. I like it. It done good. Let's take a couple stills. Let me point out, this is a sealed cooktop. It's got this little diffuser ring, and then a plate that goes on top, and it actually locks in a groove. And same way with the smaller ones. But if you gotta take them off to clean it with, and man, this stuff did a good job. See, you can see the scratches that I put in there. And you can see the areas that are really clean. See these dark spots back there? Those are the ones that are super clean because they had stuff covering them that ain't covering them no more. Cool, huh? Look, in stereo, cool. How y'all like that? I wonder, does it go up and down in stereo? Testing. Look, I do want to mention too that after you spray anything or get these little igniters wet from cleaning, they're not going to want to ignite until they dry. So what I do is simply take a cigarette lighter. Oop, that one made a liar out of me. Let me see. Oop, that one did too. If you get them real wet, I didn't get them too wet. That stuff is real thick. But you just have to light it and make it light and let it sit there and tick at you until it gets pissed off, and it'll dry out. So now you know, look, all the caps is on it. Clean, cooked up, cool. We'll get it dirty again, don't worry. Look, it's already starting to get some dirt. See there, black cooktop shows dirt, don't it? Oh well.